For his last breath, crawling in quicksand and hoping for another chance at love, bruised and fragile from past pain and struggles to reach for help. Even when I stripped her soul naked and dissected her sins to understand her flaws, she was still dancing to another man's heartbeat. It's crazy how she could juggle two hearts at the same time and be satisfied. Addicted to attention. You know that drug that is killing our generation, but I supported her bad habit and I would give her just enough. Downfall of that was when she needed a fit.
Welcome. See, they say behind every strong black man there's what? However that hinders me from what I love to do. See, I need you beside me so I can admire you and how you look. It's so beautiful. Matter of fact, how about you leading that stand behind you? Motivate you and inspire you. Help elevate you. Appreciate you. Congratulate you. Commend you. Befriend you. Help your hand. I'll lend you. And not forget to mention you how there was no one above you and how I always loved you.
Kitty's the best attribution. To this woman, the truth in many ways would die through a process of elimination, destroying the minds of the temples and the incubating carrier of God's creation. She's another fact that would pay her for the sexual sensation of vaginal penetration, but she never realizes the consequences of his ejaculation. A baby or death. With her life, she's playing another form of Russian roulette, and in the act, it's probably how she takes her final breath. Now she's lost, she's caught up in a lifestyle being pimped by her boss, and the price she had to pay was the soul that she lost. While she was still alive, she had a chance to decide. So I'm gonna be a man.
What we're doing tonight is called Confused Generation. To get her, I worked hard. But now that I gotta forget her, but when I see her with another boy, I want her confused and right. To get him, I put in work. But now that I got him, forget him, but when I see him with her, I want him confused and right. We have lost our placement, stuck in a place where love is found on the face and on the body. No one is reaching for our souls, for our internal beauty, but it's all about what I can reach for and grab first, ladies. He should have no authority to reach for anything on the outside. You are not cheap and gentle.
Yes.
Turn down the bed, turn down these voices inside my head. Lay down with me and tell me no lies. Just hold me close, don't patronize.
My sanity. It's as if she licks her lips and twists her hips just to watch and mock my fits of sexual calamity. It should be a damn crime for someone to move their waistline in such an erotic fashion. It's as if she can move without a spine with passion that could make even a priest lose his mind. This girl should be confined from public interaction. I said, I don't mean to be profane, but this fucking girl is driving me insane. It pains me to even see her smile.
Love, yes, you were the first breath of a newborn baby.
The first tear that ran down that mother's face, you were the sunset from the book of Genesis. You were the start of the day. I really felt like living. You were my beginning. You were the psalm sung into the palm of God. You were the sky. You were the prophet of light. You were your hair were the locks that chained the devil. Your essence was the flapping of angel wings. You were sent to God by amputating your wings. And I never apologize for making you human. I never apologize for doing the one thing men usually do best.
So, I take a shot. I never knew a bottle could be a parasite that would get me sick. Transfer its nature onto me until it left my mind stranded in the wilderness. I tried to put down this bottle before, but somehow it always seems to magically reappear in my hands, and I figure, hey, if this could pop out of anywhere, maybe it could do the ultimate magic trick and make my father come back to life. I pour a tsunami from the bottle into my mouth. It feels like lava.
As I hope eyes that have flight in your stomach, do not mistake them for love. Boys trap things with wings in jars. Your flight does not belong to us. Do not let us conform you to love like objects. A thing that can be touched, but doesn't know how to feel. You love men who are uncertain. You seek answers in the comfort of our hands, not knowing you can never count on us. Your worth is deeper than the first layer of your skin. So when they ask you, why is your skin so dark? Say that you are baptized in the light, and that you are the black armor of God so that you can never be bruised.
So when I think of you,